Greetings, this is Dr. Douglas Maurer from iMedical Apps with another medical app review. Today we're taking a look at an app about nutrition, specifically nutrition for clinicians. This is a topic that many of you may recall not getting a lot of information about during medical school or training in nurse practitioner or physician assistant school, etc. It seems like we've become dependent upon our dietitian and nutritionist colleagues to help our patients in many of these areas, or we attempt to use what little knowledge we have on this topic to counsel our patients. Thankfully, a group called the Physicians Committee on Responsible Medicine has put together a nutrition guide for clinicians. It is based off of content available from their website as well as a free online nutrition curriculum that they have created. Information about that is available in my online review. This app comes to us from Unbound Medicine, which makes a great number of other apps. Their app shell is consistent, works well, and has always been a favorite of mine. They make apps such as the Johns Hopkins Antibiotic Guide, which is one of my favorite apps. This app is free, so not necessarily quite as fancy as you'll see as we get going here. When you take a look, you have the ability to make favorites, make some notes, has some general introductory topics such as macronutrients and health and disease. And this is where you immediately start to see some problems. There are some nice high quality figures, but text is heavy. Scrolls well, it is well referenced. I will give them credit on that. You can get back and forth relatively quickly. But once you're in a section, there really isn't any good subsection table of contents, and you're just scrolling through literally a textbook worth of text. Nonetheless, if you are a medical student or resident, this may still be worth your time to sit down and read. But if you're hoping to use this at the point of care, you'll be a bit disappointed. Coming back out, the app has information on medical conditions. This is probably the area that is the most point of care like. So for example, in our online scenario, we had a patient who had diabetes. The patient also had pancreatitis. There's sections on that. The patient also had heart failure. And there's a section on that. Once you're in the section, interestingly, not only does it focus on nutrition, it gives you really an overall about that topic, risk factors, treatment, how to diagnose it. Frankly, information I wouldn't expect the app to have, so I guess kudos to that, but it would make the app more succinct if it left this information out, particularly since I'm not convinced all of it is up to date or will remain up to date for each of these areas. Finally, if you scroll down far enough, you will get to nutritional considerations, which is where the app kind of makes its money regarding evidence-based recommendations for each of these conditions. As you can see, it is well-referenced, includes numbers needed to treat, numbers needed to harm, and some good recommendations that you could get without having to consult a dietitian. The final portion of the app is resources for patients. Much of this comes from their own website, which you can launch to and navigate through. Again, you go through physicians, continuing education. This is where you get to that free online curriculum. There's also an entire guide for patients on a plant-based diet, 30-some page PDF that's free. And you can see they've got other websites, books. If you read my online review, Dr. Bernard is the current president and founder of the Physicians Committee. He is a well-known cardiologist and author of over 18 different books, which are featured here, as well as another famous cardiologist, Dr. Dean Ornish. There's cookbooks here, even films. Forks Over Knives, which I give a thumbs up to, having seen that documentary previously. So, There's also some information here about the physician's committee. You can see the editors, the reviewers of the content, sponsors, no drug companies here, which is nice to see, and a little bit about the committee. So overall, a nice free app, just hindered a bit by some navigation issues and its text-heavy emphasis. Things I liked about it, it's well-referenced, it has comprehensive content from a reliable source, I like these separate subsections, it's also available for Android, which is nice. Some things I didn't like, as you saw, very text-heavy content. Some of these resources in the section on resources for patients are not hyperlinked in any way. And the medical content of the condition sections may be a bit much, or at least not necessary for those of us that have other likely more reliable sources such as UpToDate or DynaMed to tell us about the treatment of asthma. But nonetheless, it's there and it is free. So this is Dr. Douglas Maurer from iMedical Apps. Take care.